In this video, you'll learn more about the Mergin Maps University Program. If you are a lecturer or student, you can apply for this program and use the perks of the free academic plan. These perks are 5 GB of storage, a free book for teachers, unlimited workspaces, and unlimited students to add to your projects. I'll first explain what Mergin Maps is, then how you can apply for the university program, and finally how you can set up a project. Let's have a look at how Mergin Maps works. Mergin Maps is a mobile app built on QGIS which allows you to collect, store, and synchronize your data with your students. Setting up your project with Mergin Maps is very easy. First, you create your survey project in QGIS. Then you synchronize the project with the Mergin Maps cloud server. After that, you can start collecting the data in the field using your mobile phone. You and your students can use configurable forms to capture any data in the field. After collecting data in the field, you synchronize the project on the phone with the Mergin cloud and then back in QGIS. The Mergin Maps plugin is used to synchronize between the cloud and QGIS, so you have all the updates from the field, from all your students, in your QGIS project. Now I'll show how to get quickly started with Mergin Maps. Let's first create an account on the Mergin Maps website. Click Sign Up. Fill in the form. While signing up, you can subscribe to the Mergin Maps newsletter. You'll receive a confirmation email with a link to verify your email. Check your spam folder if the confirmation email does not appear in your inbox after 5 minutes. Next, you'll be asked to create a workspace. To create a workspace, choose an appropriate name and click on Create Workspace. Projects, collaborations, and subscriptions in Mergin Maps are tied to workspaces. When you create your own workspace, it will automatically start with a free trial. If you are eligible for the university program, however, you can use the academia plan. I'll show you now how you can apply for that. Go to merginmaps.com/academia plan. There you'll find more information about the plan, and you can click Get Academic Plan. This will open a Google form. The academia plan is valid for 1 calendar year. After a year, you must prove your academic status again through this Google form. In the form, you can indicate where you heard about Mergin Maps. Then it's mandatory to indicate the workspace name that you've chosen before. Then choose if you're a student or a teacher, give your full name, give the name of the university you enrolled in or where you're working. Describe what you're going to use Mergin Maps for, and then give your email address that you've used to register for Mergin Maps. If you've used your university email address, you can skip the last part where you need to attach a proof of your academic status, such as a scan of your university card, a scan of a letter of enrollment, or any other document. After approval, you can use Mergin Maps with the academia plan. Let's now have a look at how to set up a project in Mergin Maps that you can use with your students. In QGIS, go to the Plugins Manager to install the Mergin Maps plugin. This plugin will link QGIS to the Mergin Maps cloud server. Now you can find Mergin Maps in the browser panel. Just scroll down and expand the Mergin Maps section. There it says double-click to configure. Now enter your username and password. You can check the box if you want to save the credentials. You can test the connection before proceeding. Here the connection is okay, so I can continue. Sometimes QGIS will ask you to set a new master authentication password. This is for the password manager of QGIS itself. So choose password and make sure you remember it. Now you can see the active workspace name in square brackets and the projects below. Those projects are in the cloud. Click right to switch the workspace to the workspace that you want to work with. In this case, I choose QuestGIS. Now we're going to create a new project. Click on the plus in the Mergin Maps toolbar. There, choose New Basic QGIS Project. It will ask you the name of the workspace and the project name. I call this project Trees and Hedges. You see that the path is automatically created here, and you can use the browse button to store it in a different location. All the files that are in that path will be synchronized with the cloud with your Mergin Maps project. In this dialog, you can also choose to make the project public so other people can use it. Click Finish. Now QGIS will load a basic Mergin Maps project, which contains open map tiles, which is a vector tiles layer, and a survey layer. Although this project already comes with a ready-to-use survey layer, I'm going to show you how to create your own survey layers. Therefore, you need to create a new GeoPackage layer. Each survey layer needs to be in an individual GeoPackage, so you cannot have multiple survey layers in one GeoPackage. Make sure you create the GeoPackage in the folder of your project so it will be synchronized with the cloud. Everything outside of the folder will not be synchronized. So here I call the GeoPackage Trees, and the table name is Trees. It's of the point type. You could change the projection to the one you want to use in your study area, but here I keep it at the default. And I create a date field and a field to indicate the species. And that will be of the text type. And later with the widgets, we can configure it in such a way that it becomes a drop-down menu where the user can select the right species. And a third field, condition. Let's create another survey layer in the same way. From the main menu, choose layer, create layer, new GeoPackage layer. Use the browse button to go to your folder where you have your Mergin Maps project. And here I create a layer called Hedges. So note that the Hedges GeoPackage is in our folder and the table name is Hedges. I want the hedges to be surveyed as lines, so I change the geometry type to line string. I keep the projection here as is. And I'm going to create a few fields. So I want the surveyor to indicate if both sides are surveyed. And that should be a Boolean type, because it should be true or false, and I add it to the fields list. Then I would like to know the number of access gates in the hedge, and that should be an integer. And finally, I would like to see a photo of the hedge, and that should be of the text type. Later, you'll see how we create widgets for these different data types. And also that the name of the field is now not human readable, but we can give it an alias in the widgets. The next step is to create the widgets. Double click on the layer or click right and select properties to go to the layer properties dialog. Go to the attributes form tab. Here we're first going to change the species attribute with the correct widget. You can give it an alias, and here, for example, you can call it species with a capital. This is what the user will see in the form and not the attribute field name. Change the widget to value map. With this, you can create a drop-down menu. Note that value is stored in the attribute table and the description is shown in the drop-down menu in the app. Now select the FID attribute. Uncheck the editable option so that it cannot be edited during the survey. FID is a special attribute used to identify features. We recommend not allowing surveyors to edit this attribute. Now select the date attribute. Because it is of the date format, the widget type is automatically set to date time. You can customize the display format. If you click the help button, you will see the options. Let's change it to day, month, year in this way. If you want the current date of the surveyor, you can use here the $now expression. I change the alias to date with a capital. Species we already did, so for condition, I change the alias to condition. And you can use here a multi-line, so the user can fill in multiple lines of text. Now let's configure the widgets of the hedges layer. Double-click on Hedges or click right and choose Properties from the context menu.
Let's start with Photo. Change the widget type to Attachment. It's very important to set the path to a relative path, so your pictures will be stored relative to the project path. Because these paths can be different on different devices, they need to be relative. Let's change the alias for Photo and change the integrated document viewer to Image, so it will show an image. Now select the FID attribute. As we've done before for the trees layer, we need to uncheck editable so the surveyor cannot change the FID. Now select the both sides surveyed attribute and change the alias to something more human readable. The widget type is automatically set to checkbox because the data type is Boolean. Now select the attribute number of access gates and change the alias again to something human readable. The widget type is automatically set to range because the data type is integer. In our case, a slider would be easy, where the user can simply use a slider to indicate the amount of access gates. I can set a minimum value, so there can be 0 access gates, and a maximum. Let's assume that there are not more than 20 access gates. Click OK. Next, I would like to limit the extent of the project, because when I zoom to the project extent, I don't want to see the whole world like here. Our study area in this example will be London, and I can use the locator bar to search for any address, but here I'll search for London. There it zooms to London, and I go to Project Properties, and there just check that Save Paths is set to Relative, so all your paths will be relative. Under View Settings, I can set the extent to the Map Canvas extent. In this way, the zoom extent for the full project will be limited to this extent. Note that there is also a Mergin Maps tab where you can configure other things that are beyond the scope of this quick start. Let's change the style of our layers using the Layer Styling panel. The Mergin Maps app on your mobile device will take over these settings. For the hatch, I choose a simple green line. For the trees, I'm going to change the simple marker to an SVG marker. QGIS comes with SVG files. Here I can search for tree, and I find a nice symbol for trees. I can change the color and the size. Note that you have to embed your SVG file, so it will be synchronized with your project. Choose Embed File, and then select the file. Now our project is ready. Let's save it, and click the Synchronize button. This will show the local changes. And when I click Sync, it will synchronize with the Mergin Maps cloud service. Now go to the Mergin Maps app on your mobile device and log in with your username and password. You can use the search box to search for your project. After it has downloaded, tap on the project and it will load. The point shows your GPS location, and you can zoom in. Tap Add to add the point. At the top, you see the survey layer that is going to be used, which is in this case survey. I can move the point a little bit to another location which I want to survey. Then I tap record and I can fill in the form. In this case, I don't want to use the survey form. I want to use trees. So I select trees. Tap record. You can see that it's not allowed to fill in the FID. The date is automatically filled in. And for species, I here see my drop-down menu that we created before. And I can type something for condition. Confirm that this is OK. And you see here that the tree symbol is placed at the location that we selected. Now let's digitize a hedge. Tap Add. From the top of the screen, select Hedges. And use the Add button to create nodes. You can move the point with your fingers and add extra nodes. When you're done, tap Record. And then you can fill in the form, and you see the widgets here that we've created. Let's add a picture. And confirm. And now you see the line in the style that we have created in QGIS. Now tap the Synchronize button to synchronize this project with the cloud. When I log into Mergin Maps, I can see our project in the dashboard. When I click on the project, I see the current files in the project. Under the History tab, I see the different versions. Version 1 was created when we initiated the project. Version 2 was when we synchronized our changes from QGIS to the cloud. And version 3 was when we changed things on the mobile app. And we can see every change in the history. Here we see the tree that has been added with its attributes. Now we can also synchronize from the cloud to our QGIS project. Click the Synchronize button. Here we see the changes. And now the changes are synchronized. Here we see the tree and hatch. Let's zoom in. With the Identify button, if I select hatches, I can see the information about this feature, including the picture. And this shows it also with the widgets that we have set in QGIS. If I select trees, I can select the tree and see the result there.
Now let's add some students to our project. In the dashboard, go to the Projects tab and search for your project. In this case, trees and hedges. Under the Map tab, you can find what we already mapped. And this is a nice way to monitor the mapping activity. Under Collaborators, you can add members. Click Share. You can add members by their email address and choose the permission. If they are a reader, they can only view projects. If they're editor, they can collect features in the project. And if they're writer, they can edit project files. You can add multiple email addresses separated by a space or a semicolon. Workspace members will be directly added to the project using their email address or username, and external users will get an invitation email. So if you add your students here with their email addresses, then they will get an email to be invited to this project. In this video, you've learned how to use Mergin Maps in academia using the academic plan.